The origin of the species.
A few still know the truth. There's around us signs, paintings, faces, documents. But we don't see. See, we are blind to our own creation.
Okay. Oh, they're gonna make this one difficult. Okay, so that's the only one that's actually can actually be maneuvered by itself. It doesn't really help. Move that one. That one's gonna go. So that messes up the outside one. So if we correct this one, and this one, there we go. It has been hidden, altered. So this glows. Sword glows. Open your eyes. Missing link. The archive. Ooh, it's not access.
Oh, crap.
Can I
do it? Will it set me free from this endless ring of time? I feel the guillotine cut my throat. The bullet hit my chest. The water fill my lungs. The blood spills out. Thick. And red. It's time to get out.
There's like nothing that actually that we can even. Okay. What? Is there an actual password here? Well, okay. Pretty much whatever you enter, I think. January 3rd, 1997. I'm writing in response to your concerns about the rising alarm in the press and the scientific community. The lack of a transitional ancestor from archaic hominids to modern mankind, Homo sapiens, is no longer safe. As you wrote, we have to act. We can't let the truth get out. They'll find out about the artifacts. It will cause too much disruption, too much chaos. Bury your constructed skeletons near Tim White's expedition in Ethiopia. We'll give them their missing link. The birth of humanity. The truth makes me sick. So they're saying that the...
My mind is gone. Lucy, I can't wait any longer. I'm ready to go.
That was weird. Vitruvian Man. And here we go. This is going to be the actual video now. Naked people.
As soon as Desmond's done, I'll initiate.
You okay?
He'd be able to explain the whole thing to us. If only we could ask him.
That is basically what Subject 16 was all about. Okay, for anybody who hasn't been caught up, Subject 16 was the person who was in the Animus before Desmond. His Desmond is number 17. But basically what had happened was he had lost his mind because they were keeping him in there for too long and he just lost it. But he was going through their archives. The Aspergo, which is the new Templar group. And finding different references to history, like more recent references. I guess. About like stuff like from the 1900s, like Hitler, Thomas Edison, Henry Ford, also Nikola Tesla. There were a lot of famous people that were kind of had files in there. that Subject 16 had like kind of put together. So at any rate, that was, oh okay, so he lost his mind. Apparently Lucy, he knew Lucy was a double agent, and he was trying to get her to or she was trying to get him to leave, or trying to like make it so that she could rescue him from there. But apparently it took too long, and he said he couldn't wait. When he says she sees me raise the knife, I think that has to do with the whole like he made it look like he was gonna kill her so that they'd shoot him and he could die and like, you know, escape from all that. But okay, there will be more about him in the next I guess the next game, actually. He has another large part in that. That's pretty much all that we know so far. That video, at the end of it, the guy says Eve. Basically, the implication, without giving away too many spoilers, is that that was Adam and Eve. And the place that they were escaping from was supposed to be like the Garden of Eden. But it wasn't the one that's like actually biblical. Okay, but that's enough from Subject 17 for now. We'll get back to that later. Right now, we are doing the, this was the DLC from Assassin's Creed 2 on the original one. These are the lost files, basically. So Ezio, right here, has got the apple. He found the apple of Eden. He discovered that the Brotherhood, he knew, like most of the Brotherhood, they're the people that we've been interacting with during the game, including like Leonardo, his uncle, Antonio. A lot of those people were actually part of this. And he decided to take the apple to here, to Forli, to give it to this woman right here, Caterina Forza, for safekeeping. So what we're going to be seeing now, I guess, in these next few sequences is the effects of that and like what happens there. So before we get into Caterina Forza, into her story, like, and what happens here, let's go ahead and read that again. We'll go ahead and get back to find out more about her, though. And we already read this earlier, but just in case like people missed it, she's born in 1463, so she's 4 years younger than him. Okay, she's a Countess of Forli. As a Countess by marriage, Caterina was notorious far before she ever arrived at Forli. Raised in the court of Milan, she received a classical education while tutored in the art of war by her father, the Duke of Milan, who died in the prequel movie Lineage. At court, Caterina also acquired a passion for alchemy and hunting. In 1473, when she was 10 years old, Caterina became engaged to Girolamo Riario, the Pope's nephew. They consummated their marriage when she was 14. Once in Rome, she was heralded as one of the most outgoing nobles at court, while her husband had a reputation for being one of the most ruthless. With the premature death of the Pope's brother, Girolamo gained even more power, securing the titles of Lord of Imola and Forli. When the Pope died, looters sacked Rome, destroying Caterina's residence. Unafraid, despite being 7 months pregnant, Caterina rode on horseback to the Castel Sant'Angelo and defended the Vatican with cannon fire and soldiers. In 1484, she moved with her family to Forli. Paid off by someone with a grievance against her husband, the Orsi brothers killed Girolamo in 1488. As a result, Caterina became the ruler of Forli and Imola, and that is the current time, 1488. Apparently, she wasted no time winning the favor of nearby rulers, revising the tax system, and training the militia herself. Although she advocated peace, when those around her were hurt, she dealt fierce vengeance, frequently killing enemies, wives, and children in punishment. While Forli was under attack by Caesar Borgia, the Pope's son, she sent the Pope a letter that had been rubbed with plague sores. Ultimately, Forli and Caterina fell to Caesar Borgia in 1499. Caterina was captured and sent to Rodrigo Borgia in Rome, who kept her in prison for a year and is rumored to have raped her alongside his son. When she emerged from the Vatican, her hair had turned white. Exiled to Florence, Caterina died of pneumonia in 1509. So here we can see, and this is kind of spoilers for what's coming up. Caesar Borgia, he hasn't actually been in it yet. He's the son of Rodrigo Borgia, who, just spoiler again, is the Pope. That was the guy that we just saw in the last episode, I believe, who believes that he is the prophet. And that's why he's been doing all this in order to get into the Vatican, because there's something there. Actually, I'm not sure that that's actually been revealed yet, or if that's like a spoiler, but okay, anyways. So that is where we are at now. Hold on, though. Let's go ahead and cheat a little bit. We'll change the cape. Put it on the Medici cape. No, wait. We'll put it on the Venetian cape. No, actually, okay. No, I think it's probably Medici cape. Oh, never mind. Okay, it's already equipped. Then we shouldn't have notoriety. Okay, Nicola Machiavelli. That's him right there. He was also born in 1469, so he's 10 years younger. Unarmed prophets have always been destroyed, whereas armed prophets have succeeded. These cynical words were written by Niccolo Machiavelli, one of the greatest minds of the Renaissance. Considered a pioneer of realist philosophy, he believed that all men are evil and will act upon their vicious nature if given the chance. The third son of a Florentine attorney, Machiavelli was tutored by his father in grammar, rhetoric, and Latin. In 1494, he entered government service as a clerk and an ambassador. Made a member of the Florentine Diplomatic Council, he was sent to the courts of France, Spain, and Rome between 1499 and 1512. This is after this game. From 1503 and 1506, Machiavelli was put in charge of the Florentine militia and the city's defense. He recruited citizens for his militia, preferring men who had a stake in Florence's continued success to dispassionate mercenaries. His strategy seemed to work in 1509 when Florence defeated Pisa. Machiavelli continued to participate in Florentine government after the Medici family was chased out. When the Medici returned, they arrested and tortured him. He was accused of conspiring against them. Unable to find any wrongdoing, the Medici exiled Machiavelli. He retired to his estate in Santa Andrea, where he wrote his famous works, The Prince, The Discourses on Livy, and the Florentine Histories. Machiavelli died in 1527. His place of burial remains unknown.
Well, well. Look who it is.
Madonna.
I thought when we met you were a bit special, but an assassin.
Okay. They met earlier in the game, if anybody missed it. When he rescued her, she was stranded on an island, and we had to go and get a boat and then like pick her up, and she spoke out for us to get us passage to Venice. Okay, accompany Caterina and Machiavelli to Forli.
Welcome, Cannon. You're going to love Forli. The cannons in Arcitadella alone go back 100 years. The artifact will be quite safe there.
Forgive you. I've never heard of a woman ruling her own city before. It's very impressive.
Well, it was my husband before, of course. He died.
Oh, sorry.
Don't be. I had him killed.
Oh.
We discovered Girolamo Riario was working for the Templars. making a map of the locations of the remaining Codex pages.
I never liked that goddamn son of a bitch anyway. He was a lousy father. Boring in bed, and a pain in my ass.
Look!
Oh no!
Why is everybody running?
Aspetta! What's happening?
They came as soon as we left the city walls, Signora. The city is under attack.
What? By who?
The Orsi brothers, Signora.
Oh, sangue di Giuda.
Who are the Orsi?
The same canaglia I hired to kill my husband.
It's the Spaniard, of course. The Orsi have no worldview bigger than yours.
But how could he know where we were taking the apple, before we even knew?
Because they're not here for the apple, Ezio. They're after Riario's map.
Basta with your map, Nicolo. My children are inside. Oh, porco demonio.
Pray for you. Okay, let's go. Don't worry, I got everybody.
They're already inside. Double-crossing bastards.
Is there another way into this place?
Aspetta. Perhaps yes. There's an old tunnel under the western wall from the canal.
Bene. I'll be right back.
Hey, you! Yeah, I'm talking to you. You spineless dogs. You occupy my city, my home.
And she's still going off. Yay! Alright, let me help these guys out. I don't actually know who it's supposed to be. Where are the bad guys? Everybody looks like a guard. Okay, forget it. Okay, so we can pretty much ignore most of the fighting. Yeah, you missed me. I don't know who to fight. I would get away. I'm away.
Ma forse per
questo che non decidete a uscire.
Wait, where is the gate? Alright, let's give this the easy way. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. We need to go up there. Oh, hey. Thanks, bruh.
You look stronger already.
Thank you. I feel stronger. I don't know if these are the bad guys or not.
You better not be looking for trouble.
Wait.
Hey! Hold on! Hey. I have a question!
I'm sorry, what were you saying? Get to safety inside the Roca di Rivoldino Caterina Citadel while protecting Caterina and Machiavelli. Sure. Okay, let's go. You guys need to go to the doctor? Anybody? Did anybody see the killer? Really? Y'all might need to change your dialogue here real quick. Boy, I hope that was one of their guys. Everybody else is just standing around. Oh, that's cool. We got this. Don't worry, let the woman fight. I thought she was still fighting. She's like, dick.
Aprite la porta! Aprite la porta, presto!
It's an ambush!
Most of them come forth immediately! We've lost the formation in the climb!
Okay, God, woman.
Bambini! But where are Bianca and Ottaviano?
Forgive me, signora. They were been inside when the attack began. I don't know where they are.
Reinforcements from the mountains! They are breaching the citadel!
Ezio, don't let those bastardi get in here!
With me!
Defend the citadel from all invaders. Okay. Did I have ammunition? Uh-oh, they're up there. Thank you. snap. Goodbye. Whoa.
Something of yours? A certain map?
And a certain apple, brother.
See? A certain apple indeed. Or shall I slice your baby's necks ear to ear?
Bastardi! You think you can threaten me? I'll give you nothing! You want my children? Take them! I have the instrument to make more!
Well, hello.
When you change your mind, they'll be in the village outside the city. You have 1 hour!
Caterina, no. I can't ask you to sacrifice your children.
Nobody's sacrificing anything. Go get them back for me, Ezio.
See, you have my word. Diablo needs to remain in the Citadel. Keep this safe.
Oh yeah. Okay, the Orsi brothers.
Gecko and Ludovico Orsi. Bored with their leisurely life in the countryside, the Orsi brothers decided to spice things up a little. They started a money-lending business that was extremely successful, mostly because they killed anyone who didn't pay them back. Then, Caterina Sforza hired them to murder her Templar husband, Girolamo Riario, which they did in true cavalier fashion. They rode up to his palace, waltzed into the dining room, stabbed him in the chest, ransacked the estate, and left his naked body in the center of town. According to Abstergo's files, Rodrigo Borgia, after escaping from Venice, offered to pay them for the recapture of the Peace of Eden. And, of course, Caterina's head. It was the Orsi brothers' idea to kidnap her children. I ask you, what has this world come to when the rich go so bad?
Okay, so we have 10 minutes to go and rescue the kids. Let's see, where are they? Up here. Probably be easier to just head out of the town and go that way. But yeah, actually we'll go through the town. That might be the easier way after all. Nope. Okay, that wall is not really gonna help. I think if we follow the tracks, and we lost the track. Nope, we found the tracks again. Oh, wait, those are bad guys. Yep. Those are also bad guys. And they're chasing me. Don't care. I'm going to rescue the children. I don't know who you guys are. get a higher view. And I see some bad guys over there. And there they are. Okay. This guy, who is apparently already done. Bianca Riario. Some people live a dream. Bianca Riario was not one of those people. 1484, at the age of 6, she witnessed the sacking of her family's palazzo in Rome and was carried by her lunatic warrior mother into a siege at Castel Sant'Angelo. Next, dragged by her family to Forlì, far more horrifying delights awaited her. Shortly after Bianca's 10th birthday, her father, Girolamo, was stabbed to death and his naked body thrown into the middle of the town square. Then her family's palazzo was sacked again and she was kidnapped by the Orsi brothers. Bianca escaped the Orsis and returned to her mother. How exactly the escape was accomplished is unknown until now. Then when she was 16, while out on a hunting expedition with her mother's new husband, Giacomo Feo, she witnessed his brutal ambush and assassination. In 1500, Bianca's mother was taken prisoner by Cesar Borgia and apparently raped by Rodrigo Borgia and Cesar. Cesar then killed Bianca's husband, Astor il Manfredi, in 1502. She married again, this time to a count, Troilo el de Rossi, who died in 1521, at which point she wisely decided to give up on life and went to her grave sometime around 1522. So this kid don't know what's in store for her. Oh crap. Not at the lighthouse. And we've only got 6 minutes. Shoot. Okay. Should have taken a horse, but. Kind of feel like we might get there a little bit quicker like this. There's the lighthouse. So we just gotta get over there. Grab the cake. This is a restricted area. No, you shouldn't be here. And once again, we're climbing the lighthouse. Did you hear that?
Can I have something to eat? Please, sit and hungry.
This is like the fourth time that we've done this, just playing this time. Pretty much got this one down.
This is your last chance, Katerina. The apple now, or I break the boy's legs.
You break this boy's leg, I break your legs. Whoops. Almost jumped off there. Bam.
Katerina was a fool to send you.
Or are you the fool, dying for a handful of change? Was it worth it?
More than you know. The Maestro gains his prize because of me.
Muori col tuo orgoglio, per quanto vale. Requiescat in pace.
Grazie, signore!
That looked like a girl. Ottaviano Riario. Ottaviano entered the service of the Florentine Republic as a condottiero when he was 19 at the request of his mother, Caterina Forza, who wanted to cement amiable relations with Florence. He commanded 100 men from Forli but terminated his contract after only a year because Florence didn't have the money to pay him. Despite accounts which describe Ottaviano as obese, brainless, and under his mother's thumb, Pope Alexander VI, that's Rodrigo Borgia, offered his daughter Lucrezia to Ottaviano. Why? Because Rodrigo decided that those were traits he could tolerate in a son-in-law as long as that son-in-law was the key to controlling the territories of Forli and Imola. Plus, his prey madness of a daughter, Lucrezia, rarely stayed married to one man for long. Her husbands tended to sign declarations of impotence or just simply disappeared. Wisely, Caterina denied the marriage, enraging the Pope and leading his son Cesare's assault on Forli. When Caterina was ousted by Cesare and entered her exile in Florence, under her guidance, Ottaviano attempted to convince the new Pope, Julius II, to give him back the lordship of Imola and Forli, but instead Ottaviano ended up selling the Riario claim to Julius for an IOU, no less. So, her kids were basically cursed. Let's just leave it at that. Whoops. And now we need to get back in there. That's also why it says repaired memory, by the way. Not because of that, because what Sean was talking about before we started, sorry about that again. Look, I'm in a hurry. Before we came here, when he was talking about, how we're going to the Vatican. That was because these memories, this whole thing with Caterina and here in Forli, was actually broken. It was incorrect memory, I guess. It was, it needed to be fixed, essentially.
What are you doing out here?
I'm so sorry, Ezio. I'm so sorry.
What happened?
It was a trick to lower our defenses.
As soon as you left, they attacked again. Gekko Orsi, he has the apple. What? No! Where is he? We chased him out here. But the bastards escaped into the mountains. I'm going.
Find and eliminate Gekko Orsi to retrieve the apple. Oh, there he goes.
Oh, no! No, no! You're not getting
that guy! You won't get far! Oops. Nope. Really? Let me take care of this archer. Now, where were we?
There he is, get him!
No. No. Bam. Scored.
So, you have your prize again.
Was it worth it? So much bloodshed.
A prize of such value, it will not remain yours for long.
We shall see. Le miserie nascono dall'avidità. Requiescat in pace.
Uh-oh. And there he is.
Lord, who are you? Stop. Don't open it.
Shave.
I don't know.
One of my guards had the luck to find you in the hills, next to Keck Horse's dead body.
That I remember. Wait, there was a third man. He took the apple.
Who?
He wore a black robe, like a monk. And I think his finger. See, Katerina, I have to go right away.
Of course. Then you will need this as well.
The map Niccolo spoke of. Your husband.
Ex-husband, mio caro. He swore he'd uncovered the locations of all the Codex pages. You will recover the apple, but you will never find the vault without this. You know, there is an abbey in the wetlands near here, where I've seen monks wearing black robes. I'd start there. Now go. Find us a Stramaladetto monk.
I think I'm going to miss you, Katerina.
Oh, I know you will.
Giacometta. Yep, we got all these. Okay. So, we're going to end this episode here. And after this, in the next episode, we'll be heading up here. We have also already got all of the codex pages, and they're on the wall. So we'll be going through those, maybe in the next episode. And kind of getting into a little bit more of what Altair wrote. And it kind of links the Assassin's Creed 1 and 2. But until then, this is a map of Italy. We can see Venice, Romagna. See kind of the locations to everything. Okay, so anyways. That was Assassin's Creed 2 from this episode. Like, comment, and subscribe as always. And have a good day.